chatting to people. You know the vibes, you know what I mean? The Young P podcast coming live every single day. Tonight we're talking about how you need to use semen retention, benefit, elevate, and maximize your potentiality. Peace. Go talk soon. Back with another video, Yao and P podcast coming live. It is your host Peace, my guy Yao. Obviously, like I said, the past few days he's still up in Massachusetts, but the wait will be over this weekend, which is approximately in 3 days. I'm pulling up on my guy, and we are posting more collaborations. So, like I said already in the intro, today's topic of discussion is going to be semen retention, why you should do it, and how it can maximize your potential. So before I start explaining why you should do semen retention, you have to first begin to visualize and envision yourself on one pillar of life, right? And then yourself on the other. When these two are conjoined, that is when you become the optimal man. That is when you become somebody who is not chasing validation, chasing female attention, chasing females, pussy, whatever else falls in that category. Instead, you are chasing self-mastery. You're chasing your higher best self. So to bridge that gap and to actually get from this stage of worldly societal traits to being this higher powered, divine human being, this male figure who understands that the true important things in life is not woman, but instead is becoming a true man who you were made to be. So by doing semen retention, which is discipline, it actually allows you to understand that the trait and the passion for short instant gratification, as in putting on XX videos or X and XX Red Tube, whatever other sites that give these demonic free pleasure releases, you know, all these type of websites, they do nothing for you to develop you as a man. They do nothing for you. Nothing in life is free but selling your soul. Essentially, every time you go on those websites and you get into this cyberspace of false reality, it sets off a certain trigger in your mind that this is really how I should be living my life. This is how I should be trying to get from here to there when it comes to females. The stuff that they do is fantasy. It is false. It is fabricated to seem like something that truly is not. I say all this to say, semen retention for me, when I did up to 80 days straight, it was very enlightening. I didn't really feel any of these nofap superpowers a lot of people prescribe to. Hair gets longer, more energy, all this. I just felt more confident based off of the discipline. I know there's lots of science and history that has been researched that actually discusses how the zinc, iron, magnesium, potassium, so many testosterone enhancing and boosting vitamin and minerals that actually are needed to get that testosterone response is actually abstained when you don't release, which is actually in semen. So when you retain and you actually begin to build up your stores, they overflow. When they overflow, that is when your testosterone grows. So as it goes, you must understand that the best way for you to become a more optimal man is to have testosterone. That is the true determining factor between men and women. We have testosterone produced more in the testicles. In that case, if you understand that by retaining, you actually will elevate your levels, you will have more confidence, more of a profound stance in life. You will not be very shaky. No one can move you. When you walk into a room, your aura will present itself. Before you introduce yourself, you will present yourself just off of your aura and your energy that will be circulating, because it is almost a subconscious, unsaid truth that you can walk in a room and know every single man that beats meet, and you do not. You can, but you do not. You have enough discipline and willpower to abstain from a worldly pleasure. You know what I'm saying? So what you must do to actually fully captivate and take this level from here it is where it's great to godly, phenomenal divinity is doing fasted training, semen retention, of course, and taking cold showers. I always take a cold shower first thing in the morning when I'm about 16 hours into my fast. I work out every day at 6 a.m. So my pre-workout is usually a cold shower. That way it's that little anti-inflammation. Sometimes my shoulders were tight in the past, but the cold actually triggers response for me to be anti-inflammatory, which means my body is no longer aching, in pain, and distress. So I'm hyped up, I'm cold, I'm fired up. Go to the gym. do my thing, you know what I'm saying? By me training fasted about 16 to 17 hours into my fasting time from the last time I had my meal, I'm now super hyperbolic, which means I'm in an anabolic state once I begin to eat my calories a few hours prior to my workout at around 1 o'clock. So by me doing all these little, as I call man-boosting practices and habits and lifestyle traits that you too will be able to do once you shift from average to great. You know what I'm saying? To get from average to great, you have to implement self-induced disciplinary actions every single day in your life. And by you doing that, you will actually captivate and manifestate in your life your true best self. So with that being said, like, comment, subscribe, comment down below what it is that you have been saying you want to do and you've been struggling to accomplish. Let's get you from this, as I said, societal man to the higher divinity, higher powered male version that you truly have potentiality to become. If you're from here to there, it's your responsibility. Hit me, follow me on IG at Panther Wisdom and at Panther Fit Season. Tags are right here. Also, my brother, follow my boy, the fashion king, the soccer star, none other, top two and not two, Yao Stone, Adam, right here. We're going to be taking this channel to the moon. Like I said, it is just the beginning. So please comment what you guys need next. If you have it, we got it. Plain and simple. Peace.